you know that Ted Bundy's first dog, a collie, was named Lassie? Had you heard this?
Who's Ted Bundy?
Forget it.
There is an idea of a Patrick Bateman, but there is no real.
No, I'm in touch with humanity.
New card. What do you think?
Look at that.
Picked them up from the printers yesterday.
Good coloring.
That's bone. And the lettering is something called Cillian Rail.
Need that job anyway. See why you just don't quit.
Because I want to fit in. I can't believe that Bryce prefers Van Patten's card to mine.
Let's see Paul Allen's card.
So goes out with that loser Patrick Bateman. What a dork.
Another martini, Paul.
Spineless, lightweight.
Something wrong?
Patrick?
You're sweating.
What about dinner?
Is that all you ever have to contribute, Van Patten? What about fucking dinner?
Cheer up there, Bateman. What's the matter? No shiatsu this morning?
Touching me with that drawback stuff.
Hold on there, little buddy.
No. No smoking, not in here. No, put it in the cart.
Stop. My name is Patrick Bateman. I'm 27 years old. I believe in taking care of myself.
You can always be thinner, look better.
In a balanced diet, and a rigorous exercise routine.
My God, Bateman, you want me to fry you up some fucking potato pancakes? Some latkes?
Ask me a question.
So what do you do?
Don't you want to know what I do?
No, not really. You have a really nice place here. How much did you pay for it?
Well, actually, that's none of your business, Christy. But I can assure you, it certainly wasn't cheap.
Your address? American Gardens Building, West 81st Street.
Nice.
Very nice.
Thanks.
Get a goddamn job, Al. You got a negative attitude. That's what's stopping you. You gotta get your act together. I'll help you.
You are so kind, Mr. B. You're kind. You're a kind man.
Al. I'm sorry. Just a... I don't have anything in common with you.
And though I can hide my cold gaze, and you can shake my hand and feel flesh gripping yours, and maybe you can even sense our lifestyles are probably comfortable, I simply am not there.
Hey, Floyd, what do you say?
Hey, Hamilton, have a holly jolly Christmas.
Tonight, I just have to kill a lot of people!
If you don't shut your fucking mouth, I will kill you.
I like to dissect girls. Did you know I'm utterly insane?
Murders and executions, mostly.
I want to stab you to death, then play around with your blood. I need to engage in homicidal behavior on a massive scale.
I couldn't tell you that, Halberstram. But then I'd have to kill you.
Hey, Paul! Ah!
I killed another girl with a chainsaw. I had to. She almost got away. Someone else there, I can't remember, maybe a model, but she's dead too. And Paul Allen. I killed Paul Allen with an axe in the face. His body is dissolving in a bathtub in Hell's Kitchen.
There are no more barriers to cross. All I have in common with the uncontrollable and the insane, the vicious and the evil, all the mayhem I have caused, and my utter indifference toward it, I have now surpassed. My pain is constant and sharp, and I do not hope for a better world for anyone. In fact, I want my pain to be inflicted on others. I want no one to escape. But even after admitting this, there is no catharsis. My punishment continues to elude me, and I gain no deeper knowledge of myself. No new knowledge can be extracted from my telling. This confession has meant nothing.